Okay, and we're back. We had a great dinner here. Hopefully, in Amsterdam, in Hoofddorp, you had the same. Without further ado, we have Harry van Butten. Please take it away.
Okay. Thank you very much. My name is Harry Rautio. I'm the CEO of the Butten Corporation. I now have I've been told 6 minutes to tell you the story of my startup, the Butten. I have a lot of slides, so I'm going to just skim through them and tell you the story of the Butten Corporation. Before I begin, hands up, how many of you have heard of this particular Butten before that I'm going to present to you? Two. Okay, great. Virgin audience, welcome. Okay, the story goes back 12 months. So a year ago, I was sitting having beers. All good stories begin with a beer, right? And we were trying to get the waiter to our table, or I think it was she was a waitress. We couldn't alert her in any way. You know, Finnish restaurants, very bad service normally. So my friend said, I wish there was a button that we could press and the lady would. At the same time, I was telling my friend a story about my mother, not her particularly, but the same age, and how she tries to survive in her home. And she hates all new technology. She hates smartphones. Her blood pressure is fluctuating, and she needs help every now and then, but I'm not there, my sister is not there, but she wants to live at her own, right? And how to give her the new technologies in the way that she could utilize that. And that's where the idea of a general push button, a physical push button that would always be connected to the internet, started. That's where we started, and that's the journey that I'm presenting with. So it with a real couple of real use cases, and then after that I tried to kill the idea for 3 months. Why? Because, well, ideas come cheap, and a lot of you have a lot of us have a lot of ideas. The best idea is a dead idea, because if it's not dead, then you're going to start progressing with it and it takes your time and your money, and normally they don't end up well. So far, so good with this company now. Okay, so after 3 months, and this was earlier, it was summer, now it's exactly a year ago, the company started. I tried to spar it with several friends of mine. One, no censored. but anyway, the point of this picture is, this is October 2013, and we are starting the company, and then we started to plan what the button could look like, and this was where we came up with ourselves, and this is an engineer's view of the internet connected button. The idea of this is that it's really self-sustained. It connects to the internet with either 3G or with Wi-Fi, and that is the real product now, as per the original idea. And it's meant for human hands, so it's easy to press. And if you want to see inside, it will look like that. There's slot for batteries too, so it's really self-sustained. Okay, time goes on. A couple of months later, we have a 3D printed version of the button. Today, it's really great to be an entrepreneur. We have all kinds of funding mechanisms. We have 3D printing. We have fast route to development. You can buy servers from the net. Really, the execution time is really much shorter than it used to be. So I'm really happy to be an entrepreneur today. Okay, so we're all eager to press the button there and smiling and happy. Also, a lot of handwork relating. It feels like going back to preschool where we were doing this askartelu in Finnish. I don't know what that is, but anyway, you put a lot of glue together and pile of paper, and then you wish something would come out. Okay, real hardware stuff too. We were trying to fit in a mobile phone and a Wi-Fi antenna and a computer push button trigger them all to the plate. And so it's real hard work. Okay, then ideas come cheap, but then you need customers, right? So one of the first customers, by the way, there are some of the real ones that we are now selling and delivering. One of the real first customers was a company called Finkino, who is now it's the biggest movie theater chain in Finland, and they're using this as an in-theater call button. If something happens during the movie, you need a mechanism to tell the staff that something happened. Maybe you lost the audio, maybe the guy to you just is having a heart attack or something. So you never know. It's pretty nice to go to a movie theater now and see our own button there. Next time you go, the Finnish people here, pay attention. There's buttons on the walls. Okay, moving on with the story. Then we thought, okay, this is ugly. This is okay, usable, but it's not meant for global distribution. That what's missing? Okay, the product needs more sex. Who do you call? Well, you call this guy. His name is Harri Koskinen. He's the famous Finnish industrialist. And I told him, hey, can you take an assignment? Please design for us a real tempting push button that anybody walking by would just love to come and press. No need for manuals. Doesn't look like an emergency brake. And then he's famous, for example, for the block lamp and a lot of stuff. If you Google him, there are a lot of good stuff comes up. Hey, now comes another good stuff. This is his design work. Now that's the product now that we are selling. And it contains all the same parts, but it looks friendly. It looks inviting. Even my mother could use that, I would say. Okay, then in the beginning of last June, we our website and started selling it. That's also a great thing of today. You can do pre-orders. We don't have it done yet, but hey, please show your interest, support us and pay and yeah, and then we will deliver in October. We need money all the time. Startups are bad things, they need money all the time. So but seriously, to start the factories and so on, we need it. So that's okay. The URL is missing now. T.tn. So we try to be very simple in both the product and the URL and the brand. So they're all the same. BT.tn button. Okay. You do with the button. I won't go into details. This is not a sales pitch. Go to our website if you are interested, but this is our server. So the button does nothing else but connects to our server, and then the magic happens in the server. So we can do a lot of things, from Facebook updates when you press the button all the way to a REST API, which is today's way of connecting to your back end. So that's what it is. And then what really happens, you press the button, our server gets notified, then you can do your own actions or you can select from a lot of other actions, and then say magic happens. So you can very easily create yourself a pizza ordering button. That's a cool way to impress your friends, by the way. Okay, identified for business as a business strategy two main areas where to use the button and where we really hard push it. You can order it from web and you can do whatever you want with it, but where we are taking marketing actions is in the smart home. Use that as the ultimate user-friendly and family-friendly. She can also use that, by the way. Controller for your smart home, or offer this for service ordering platform for B2B companies. For example, taxi, logistics, transportation, etc. Okay, so now the team is a little bigger than what it used to be. We have the roundish PCB, the board, now ready too. So and that's what it looks like controlling a smart home environment. So place that by your bed, and in the morning you wake up, then your home wakes up. The curtains open up, your temperature goes up a couple of degrees, your lights turn on, and your doors disarm. All kinds of magical things you can put behind. So it's pretty good instead of going downstairs and starting typing into your keypad. That's a check-in for your kids when they come home from school. She can press the button. You will get an SMS. Oh, daughter is home. Okay, great. Okay, order taxi at the reception. the lounge of Tekes, by the way. She asked me, the girl, when I went there, to okay, what do you want? Please call me a taxi. Okay, I'll do that. She says, what does your company do? I said, we make taxi ordering buttons for people like you. She came to hug me. That I'm calling taxi 40 times a day. Okay, picture of smart home. Okay, that's me at an exhibition. This picture is internationalization. Now we've started our international sales too. So here I am at TechCrunch Disrupt event lab, trying to break to the American market. And that's a button to order beer if you want. Here are some samples to the end. If you want a pickup truck that would come, no more calling and waiting in the line anymore. Just some samples. Just samples I want to underline. Okay, that's about it. I don't know how many minutes it was, but I want to thank you. If you have any questions, email me at harry@bt.tn. I can also, do I have some questions now? Maybe a couple?
Yep. You have one on.
There, yeah. Yeah, lovely question. What I say, the universe has to change when you press the button.
Yeah.
Otherwise, what happens? You press it again.
Yeah.
So we have a light rim around the button. When you press it, yellow circle starts in a couple of seconds. As the transaction is completed, you get red or green light back, and that stays on for 10 seconds. So you have instant feedback, my order go through or not. For taxi ordering and that thing, we also have a relay of SMS, let's say, to the doorman. If there's two customers, you press it once, twice, the doorman gets two SMS, taxi number 101 is coming, and then a second later, taxi number 206 is coming. So then he can tell that to the real customers. That's very important. The feedback is everything. Yeah.
Canceling,
very good. Within first 5 seconds, if it was oops, then you press it for 5 seconds, a long press, that's cancel.
Okay.
Yeah.
Still mentioning pre-order.
Yeah, very good. Right now, Indiegogo. So Kickstarter is the biggest one. Indiegogo.com is the second biggest crowdfunding platform. Our campaign is on. Thank you for asking that. So everybody go to Indiegogo.com. Order one button. We will deliver next month, just in time for Christmas. If you have a son or a nephew or somebody who doesn't have this, and I bet he doesn't have the button, give him a button. Questions?
No.
Yeah?
Why not make the button location aware?
Now you're talking roadmap. Looking at installing a GPS chip into the button. But right now what you do is, for example, with taxi, you go and type the address on our back end. It asks two questions. What is your serial number of your button, and what is the address where you want the taxi to come? Very simple. After that, it works. Okay, my time's up. Thank you. And talk to me later. Send me email, whatever.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That was amazing. Yeah, please give the mic to Sever. No, Sever's here. Yep. And ancient audio not working in a theater, that will never happen at Sonoma.